tell me what I've done wrong.
You forgot your pen when you were paying your bill.
Oh, thanks. I'm not usually this chaotic. Nerves, I suppose. I still haven't quite got my bearings, I'm afraid.
Well, you'll take the Ashfordley Road from here, then look for the Elsenby sign, and go along that road there to the seafront and turn right. You can't miss it.
Thanks again. You know, it's a great place you have here. Hope I'll be dropping in again soon.
Well, we're always here. Good luck.
Thanks. Bye.
Ta-ra.
I'm telling you now. I'm telling you right away. I'll be saying for many a day, I'm in love with you now. I'm telling you now. I'll say what you wanna hear. I'll be telling you for many a year, I'm in love with you now. Think I'm fooling when I say I love you. I love you. Maybe you'll believe me when I'm finally through, 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 through. I'm telling you now.
Excuse me. Hello, excuse me.
Go on, I'm not deaf.
Where can I park?
Your patient or visitor?
Neither.
Oh.
I'm here for an interview.
Oh, well, I reckon you can park in one of the doctor's spaces over there.
Thanks.
Must be mad to want to work here.
Good luck.
To empty that occasionally.
I do. I wait till after morning surgery. It doesn't need emptying so often. You see, people tend
to... Good morning, good morning.
Oh, you're rather early, Mr. Rose.
I have a busy day. Get them to jump to it, Matron.
Inform Staff Nurse Taylor that His Majesty's arrived. Dr. Ormerod's his anaesthetist today, Lizzie. So put his lights up, please.
Well, Dr. Ormerod's not...
Yes. Yes, indeedy. Well, that will have to come out. Right away. Good of you to join us, nurse. Straightforward gallbladder. Wheel him in. I'll do him first.
There may be a slight problem, Mr. Rose. Dr. Ormerod's your anaesthetist today. He isn't answering his lights.
Why on earth not? Where is he?
Well, we're trying to find out.
He'll be aware of the urgency, Mr. Rose. He is the patient's GP.
I have an outpatient in Ashfordley and hemorrhoids in Scarborough. I can't wait all day for you lot to pull your finger out. Don't scowl, sister. Kills the germs. Kills the germs.
Honestly, that man.
Your name's David Cheriton, you say?
Yes, that's right.
No, I don't think so.
I assure you it is. I ought to know my own name.
No, I mean, I don't think you've an appointment. It's not in the book.
Dr. Way wrote to me offering the interview. Today's day, look.
Well, he hasn't confirmed it in the book. We have a system, you see. You're not down as an appointment.
Well... Can't you just let Dr. Orwin know I'm here? I have come all the way from London.
No. Morning surgery started. I'm only allowed to interrupt if it's urgent.
I don't want any flannel middle ditch. I want an anaesthetist here now.
Dr. Ormerod, any idea where he is, Lizzie?
I was told to put his lights up, but there's no point. He's not back from his rounds yet.
This is ludicrous. I'm kept waiting because he's pottering about on GP business. Sort it out, men. Sort it out.
Can you track him down?
He's up on the moors. I phoned about 10 minutes ago. His wife wants the car to go shopping. I've got the number here somewhere. This gentleman says he's an appointment, Mr. Middleditch.
Oh? In connection with... I'm sorry, T.J. Middleditch, hospital secretary.
How do you do? I'm here for an interview.
Oh, right, yes, indeed. But can you just hang on a tick?
Lizzie at the hospital again. Is Dr. Ormerod still with you?
Yeah. But my wife's just about to...
You're doing very well, Mrs. Crack.
Now don't push, all right? Just pass.
Doctor! It's hospital again!
Right. Look, just keep breathing deeply, all right? I'll be back in a second. Thank you. Lizzie, if my wife's still on about the car, tell her you can't find me. Well, no, I can't leave Sharpish. I'm in the middle of a sudden labour. Well, ask Dr. Allway to step in. Bless you, Lizzie. Thank you. Midwife's on her way. You wouldn't make us all a nice cup of tea, would you, Mr. Craig? She's doing fine. You're doing fine, Jean!
Doctor always seen a patient. Shall I interrupt him?
Yes, I think you better. You see, all our doctors have their own general practice patients, apart from their hospital duties.
Don't you have bleepers to contact them?
Pardon me?
Bleepers. Electronic communication devices?
Oh, good Lord, no. No, this isn't London. Far too expensive. Anyway, I doubt if they'd work around here with all these hills. No, I'm afraid we're a little behind when it comes to newfangled gimmicks. Well, come round, will you?
Are you getting anything? Unless it's an interlude showing a snowstorm, no, we're not.
Definitely needs an outside aerial.
Hey, it's not bad, though, is it? Only cost me £8.
You reckon old Middleditch will cough up for it?
Well, he's just got for £20 from the League of Friends jumble sale. I mean, the patients would love a chance to see a bit of telly.
Alan, patient in Milner Ward to go through.
Right. Hey, you'll have your work cut out persuading him.
Well, look, if he won't play, I can always go see old Doc Allway. I can always win him round.
Dr. Allway?
Yes?
Mr. Rose told me to remind you he's been ready for some time.
Goodness sake, I've been writing up the pre-meds. Alan's taking the patient through now. Tell His Majesty 2 minutes.
He's the reason we're all here.
Sorry?
My grandfather, who endowed the place. Royal on account of him having persuaded the Duke of Clarence to open it, and free on account of him having made a fortune mining whinstone. He wanted to put something back into the community. James!
Yeah?
James, this is... Oh, I'm sorry, what was the name again?
David Cheriton.
David Cheriton, Dr. Allway.
Oh, I'm pleased to... Oh, Cheriton! Of course, I'm so sorry, I'm a bit up to my eyes. You've come to have a chat about joining the practice.
Well, I'm here for an interview, yes.
Yes, yes, well, I'm afraid we're all rather... My colleagues, the other two doctors in the practice, they're out on call, and I'm just standing in for one of them at an op. Why don't you come and observe?
What a good idea.
Mr. Rose is our distinguished visiting surgeon. He pops over from Ashfordley once a week or so. I'll slowly count to five. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Do hurry up, let's have him in.
He's only just been induced. Oh, if it's all right, Dr. Cheriton is here to observe.
As long as he doesn't waste my time asking damn fool questions.
Right, there we are. Let's get him settled.
You're right, Doctor.
Fine. Turn the halothen down to 0.5, would you want?
Is he ready?
Mm-hmm.
Scalpel. Bleak incision, just below the diaphragm. And clip.
Dr. Allway.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
I'm underway. Take him out. Not you, Doctor. You'll have to take over on the anaesthetics.
Me?
But don't butt me, man. I can't have the patient coming round mid-op. The shock could kill him.
Sister Bridget to organise a bed and an intravenous infusion. I want him examined at once.
Who's available?
Dr. Omrod's still out on call. Dr. Wetherill's just got back.
But put our lights up, for goodness sake.
Do you think that young man will be able to cope in the theatre?
He'll just have to, won't he?
Awkward little blighter. Damned adhesions everywhere. I need another 15 minutes at least. Hot pack, please, nurse.
Ooh.
Well, yes, I'll be back as soon as I can. How is he?
We have everything under control. Dr. Wetherill's with him now. The intravenous drip's on its way, Doctor.
I must get back to the patient.
James, you're not going anywhere. Lie down.
Jill, what's happened?
You've given us all a bit of a shock. That's what's happened.
It's your duodenal ulcer. It's hemorrhaged.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm right as rain.
Don't be absurd. You must have lost a lot of blood, Doctor.
No.
Now, keep still. Let Sister have your arm.
Watch the milk and alkaline drip down your nose. That'll get you quiet.
That's it. All ship-shape and Bristol fashion. Good job you seem to know your way around the old laughing gas.
Took a diploma in anaesthetics after my house 1 year, while I was at Guy's.
Why on earth join a godforsaken outpost like this? Good anaesthetist, a thin on the ground.
I like patient contact. I felt a cottage hospital might be the best of both worlds. My MGP patients plus some operating theatre sessions.
Young chap like you ought to have more ambition. Never make a name for yourself in a backwater like this.
Ta-da! Yep, 14-inch screen, walnut veneer surround, gets both channels.
Ken, I have already told you, a television set for the patients will only cause problems.
No, no, I've asked them. I mean, they'd love a telly,
eh? Well, of course they will. They'll squabble over it. For a start, will it go in Milner Ward or Fawcett?
Well, they could take it in turns. The men could have it on a Saturday for the sports and the women could have it on another day.
And who decides whether to watch the BBC or the... Oh, God, what do they call it? The commercial station?
Well, they can put that to the vote.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Ken. It's a recipe for discord.
Well, perhaps we should ask Doc Allway what he thinks.
Doc Allway is very poorly. Now is not the moment.
Oh, poor soul. It was only yesterday at the League of Friends jumble sale calling out the bingo.
Well, he drives himself too hard. That's the problem. All his spare time is devoted to the hospital.
He was saying, he hoped some of the cash raised could go to cheering up the wards. I mean, happy patients get better quicker, so he reckons.
And a television set is a prescription for happiness, is it?
Be a shame to miss the opportunity.
How much?
Well, as I say, it's in good nick and I have to haggle as it is. And then, of course, there's the cost of it transporting over.
How much?
How does £8.10 sound?
£8? And that's to install the set in working order, yes?
Ah, no. Well, I may need, say, another 30 bob to, buy and install an aerial.
In other words, £10. John Logie Baird has got a lot to answer for. There we are.
Very lucky you were on hand.
Well, Midlado seems to have survived. Have sister keep him on fluids only for 24 hours, then a low-fat diet once his bowel sounds return.
I've postponed the rest of Mr. Rose's list until next week. No further theatre duties today, nurse. You're free to get back to casualty.
Think about what I said. Always on the lookout for promising young chaps at Ashfordley.
You are honoured. Doesn't take to everybody.
Where's Dr. Roy? Thanks very much. Oh, I'm sorry.
He's nodded off.
Good thing, too. Rest is what he needs.
So you were with him when it happened?
Yes. It needn't be too serious. Duodenal ulcers are treatable nowadays, even after a hemorrhage.
Really?
Oh, yes, I assure you. There's really nothing for you to worry
about. My pretty little head about, right?
Well, it's always an anxious time when friends or loved ones are taken ill.
Indeed, indeed. But just in case, I have had his blood cross-matched. I've put him on an intravenous regime, strict gastric diet, and minimum 7 days bed rest to be reviewed.
I'm so sorry. I thought that...
Yeah, I'm Dr. Wetherill. Yeah. David Cheriton, I presume?
Yes, that's right.
Right, well, we'll be meeting later to discuss the vacant post.
Ah, you've met Dr. Wetherill, I see.
No one told me she was a woman.
Well, don't let that put you off. She's really rather good.
So, Sorry I'm late. I had a sudden labour.
Next week I'd appreciate an anaesthetist on standby in theatre at 0900. Sharp.
Gaby's name is Cheriton, but he's not down in my book officially.
Well, never mind, is he? Sounds like he saved the day.
Messages for you. It's been like a madhouse this morning. Where are they?
How's Dr. Allway?
Having a sleep. Here we are. Matrons postpone the rest of Mr. Rose's operations. Your wife called, says if the car keys aren't in reception when she gets here, she's filing for divorce.
Well, that'll be the third time this week.
And Dr. Wetherill wants to see you.
Pulse is down. Blood pressure's okay. Seems like the ulcer's stopped bleeding. He needs complete bed rest and very long recuperation.
Well, that makes a new appointment even more urgent, then.
Well, more important, certainly. Look, James was planning to bow out gradually, wasn't he? But he's unlikely to return at all now. I think it's absolutely vital that we find the right person as his replacement.
Well, this Cheriton bloke seems to have kept a cool head this morning, by all accounts.
Yeah, but there's others who've applied. Look, there's Keith Bannon from Edinburgh. There's Mary Gullick from Manchester.
We need another anaesthetist. Bannon isn't qualified in that area.
No, but Mary is.
Look, I know she's a friend of yours, but Dr. Gullick can't join us for another 2 months, can she?
She is very, very committed. Come on, women doctors have such a tough time. We'd be helping her and ourselves if we just waited.
We need someone quickly, Jill.
We can get a locum to fill in till we make a permanent appointment.
Well, why wait? If we've got the right man here and now.
Well, he's a man, all right, yes. He struck me as a typical public school male. And I bet he plays rugby as well.
Sorry, but Mrs. Rutter, patient of Dr. Allway's, telephoned. Daughter's got terrible tummy pains. I thought it best not to tell her about Dr. Allway.
Well, I've got a ward round now. Look, we've had a lot on Lizzie. Can't the mother bring her in?
Well, she sounded very worried. And her husband's out with the car.
Right.
Can't interest you in buying a brand new colour set then, my friend. All the rage, these are now, you know.
No, I've already got a telly, thanks very much. It's the aerial I'm after.
Oh, very wise. TVs don't work without an aerial, old chum. Now, let's see. Yeah, here we are, the latest aerial comes in at £3.19 and sixpence.
Nearly £4. That's a bit steep, isn't it? I mean, it is for the patients at the cottage hospital.
Oh, business is business, Squire.
Well, what if I pick one up second-hand? How much would you charge to install it?
Well, now, that's different, Squire. I mean, you didn't buy the set here. You haven't purchased the aerial from us. Well, you can hardly expect a discount. I mean, there's the call out of a van with ladders, trained engineer, labour. No, you're looking at 50 bob minimum.
You're joking.
Erecting a television aerial's a very skilled task. No, that's the best I can do, my friend.
Right, well, no hire, Squire. Shove it, matey. Jump up, pal.
Dr. Wetherill, a partner in Dr. Allway's practice.
Oh, I see. Oh, you'd best come in. My husband's at work. I have phoned him. I don't dry myself, you see. Sally, the doctor's here to see you.
Hello there, Sally. How are you feeling?
Not too good.
You've got a bit of a tummy ache.
Yeah.
You've been vomiting, have you?
Yeah.
Could I have your hand, do you think? There we are.
Okay. When did you first start getting these pains?
In the middle of the night.
And could you show me where it hurts, do you think?
My tummy. You're here.
Right. Let's pop this up for you.
There. About there.
Ah, no, please.
Any particular reason you wanted to leave the big city? It's gone to the back and beyond.
Swinging London isn't always cracked up to be, you know.
You've no special ties there, then?
Sure, it'll be the country air and a nice bit of peace and quiet you're after, isn't that right, Doctor?
Absolutely.
Ah, Dr. Cheriton, there you are. Dr. Ormerod would like a word. His consulting room's down the corridor on the left.
Right, thank you.
Good luck.
Shouldn't you be in casualty, nurse?
Oh, it was very quiet. I left Nurse Hopkirk in charge while I took my break.
Well, don't be long. She's still very inexperienced.
Something tells me you'd not be against that young fella getting the job.
Well, be nice to have a new face round here.
A new man's face, you mean?
Yeah. But knowing Dr. Jill, she'll hold out for some female colleague.
I'd like to get her into hospital as soon as possible.
What is it? What's wrong?
Well, I need a closer examination, but I think that she may have a cyst on her ovary, which has twisted.
Oh, no.
It's not that uncommon, really. If we operate quickly enough, she should be fine. Do you have a telephone I could use?
Yes, of course. It's downstairs in the hall.
Thank you.
Thanks for stepping in this morning, Dr. Cheriton.
You cope very well.
Please, I can help out.
What do you make of what you've seen so far?
Well, it's certainly different from a London teaching hospital.
Yes. Well, the thing about a cottage hospital such as ours is that, well, we as GPs get to treat our own patients during their stay in hospital. Another advantage is that we have close contact with their families and so on.
What happens with specialist treatment? A brain tumour, say?
Referred to Ashfordley or Scarborough. Mm. Although they get to return here to recuperate with us, you know, under their own GPs. Look, it may be worth mentioning, David, that in a rural area such as this, a doctor's work calls for personal skills, as well as medical ones. It's how you relate to people, really. One's manner, that's important. I'm afraid it doesn't suit everybody.
I realise I may have got off on the wrong foot with Dr. Wetherall.
Excuse me. Ormerod. Yes, Lizzie. Yes, put her through.
Gordon, look, I've got a young girl here who may have a torsion of an ovarian cyst. She's shocked and she's in quite a lot of pain.
Well, get her in here right away.
Yeah, ambulance is on its way. Hey, look, I'd like Rose to have a look at her if possible.
No, I'm afraid he left a while back. Look, can't you get her into Ashfordley?
No, that's too risky. We're going to have to move quickly on this one. Listen, can you get Nurse Taylor to prepare the operating theatre for me?
From my cousin's builder's yard, and all we've got to do is stick it up.
It's a bit rickety, sure it'll work.
Oh, it works all right, yeah. Only came down because the house was getting demolished. By the way, are you busy later on?
Not as far as I know, why?
Oh, well, you could do your good deed for the day. Sally?
Dad?
Who are you? What's going on?
John, the doctor says that Sally needs to...
Where is he? Where is Olwey?
He's indisposed, I'm afraid. I'm one of his colleagues. I'm Dr. Wetherill.
Oh, are you? What's wrong with my daughter? She was fine last night.
Well, I think she may have a cyst on her ovary. We need to get into hospital for an exploratory operation and then...
Whoa. Hold up. You think she has a cyst? And who exactly is going to be doing this operation?
Well, Mr. Rose from Ashfordley General, but if he's not available, then me, probably.
Oh, no. I'm not having my daughter cut open by some slip of a lass.
John! Mr. Rutter, Sally really is in an acute condition.
Acute?
I really need to get it.
What are you talking about? Sally?
Dad? I hear so much.
It's all right, love. Don't worry. All right. But if she needs an operation, I want a proper surgeon.
OK, I'll ride with her.
Me off with some jumped up woman GP. It's a good thing I got here.
Have you managed to get hold of Rose?
Matron's still trying. I'm Dr. Olmrod, Mr. and Mrs. Rasser.
Well, perhaps I can get some sense out of you. How come Dr. Olway couldn't come out to see her himself?
Well, I'm afraid he's unwell. Just leave her to us.
Listen, I would like a second opinion before we operate.
Second opinion? You see, she's no idea what she's doing.
It's all right, Sally. Won't take long.
Perfect in business.
Can you see if Matron's managed to get hold of Rose yet? Okay.
All right. Can you just turn on your side, please?
Yes, I'm sure Mr. Rose has gone to lunch. It is lunchtime, after all. The question I asked you is, where is he? Well, where does he usually have his lunch? Then please find out and phone me back. This is an emergency. That lot. They couldn't run a bath, never mind a hospital.
John Rutter is a difficult man. He could make trouble for us.
That, if I may say so, is entirely irrelevant. It's his daughter's well-being we're concerned with here.
You all right?
Yeah, it's my legs.
Don't worry, I'll get you out, mate.
No, my legs, they're trapped.
Right. Don't worry, I'm going to go and get some help.
Panda 1 to control, are you receiving? Over. Panda 1 to control, are you receiving? Over. Can you hear me, Alf?
Ladies, don't worry, soon I'll have a nice clear picture for you. Right,
fix that to the side of the chimney and run the cable down the side. Easy peasy.
You should get a proper bloke in.
Alan, lad, I've told you, I can't afford to.
How much did Middleditch give you?
Oh, barely enough to cover the cost of the set.
You sure?
All right, I got the aerial on the cheap, so there's a bit left over for the beer fund. All right, I will buy you a couple of pints. Now, please, just get up there.
Right, I'll fix this chimney, but if I'm needed, you'll have to sort out cable yourself.
This is all I'm saying.
I still can't find Mr. Rose.
You're right. We must operate immediately.
Come along, then. Get the theatre prepared for her.
What's going on?
We're going ahead.
We must operate quickly, Mr. Rutter.
Are you sure about this?
There's no question. You're going to have to sign a consent form.
Have you done many operations like this before?
Well, I won't be operating. Dr. Wetherill here is our gynaecologist.
Oh, no. Absolutely not. I want a man. A proper surgeon.
Don't be ridiculous. Dr. Wetherill is a proper surgeon. Your daughter couldn't be in safer hands.
Mr. Rose is the expert. I want to wait for him.
John, please.
Mr. Rutter, if we don't operate now, your daughter may lose her ovary. She may even die.
All right, if I,
Sure. I've written your details into the appointments book now. Your meeting's official.
Jolly good. So they never seem to be available to hold a meeting.
Yeah. We're very busy. Patients are our priority. That's what Dr. Orway always says. He's a patient himself now. Funny that.
It'll be very weak post-op, so she'll need to be specialed on 24-hour obs.
I'll make sure that Sister Bridget has a bed prepared.
Lizzie, I'm going to need Alan in the theatre.
I think he was with Ken doing something.
Oh, for goodness sake, Lizzie, go and find him. This is an emergency.
St. Aidan's Royal.
Look, I'm sorry about this, David. It's,
yeah, okay.
It's one of those days, I'm afraid.
No, that's fine.
Okay, just hang on a
Shall
second.
I hang on, or...?
Excuse me, Dr. Olmrod. I have to go and find Alan. Constable Bellamy, Ashford Police. Accident on the moors. Driver's hurt.
Okay. Hello, this is Olmrod.
I've got a lorry driver. He's trapped in the cab. Now, I've called an ambulance and the fire brigade.
Well, how is the injured man?
Well, he's in a lot of pain. It's his legs that are trapped. They could be broken.
Well, how lucid is he?
Well, he's very chatty. Look, you're nearer than Ashfordley. Shall I send him to you?
Well, just one moment, please, Constable. Look, I know this is most irregular, but you couldn't help us out again, could you, David?
Be more than happy to. What's the problem?
Well, we may have a broken leg coming in before we're finished in theatre.
Fine. I can deal with that.
Marvellous. Yes, get him in here. Stay with him, all right? And call us if he loses consciousness. And on no account let him have any fluids.
Right. I will do. Thank you.
Thanks.
This chimney stack's in poor shape. Needs repointing.
I know. I've been on to Middle Ditch about it loads of times.
What on earth are you doing up there? You're needed in the theatre, now.
Nearly finished, matron.
It's not my job to chase up junior staff. I said now, and I mean now.
And Potter, she got any water?
I'm sorry. The doctor didn't advise it.
What about with something a bit stronger? Let's not risk drinking when I'm still behind the wheel, eh? Not you being a copper.
I'll just take it easy now, all right?
Hey, we'll soon have you out of there.
It's all right, love. It'll be over before you know it.
See you soon, sweetheart.
So quick. Last night she was laughing, she was chatting.
Come on, John. Let's just leave them to it now. Eh?
Indeed. Why don't we go and have a cup of tea in my office? Oh.
Right. If you want a job doing, Ken, do it yourself.
Anything else?
Is there anywhere to operate or we have to reset his fracture?
We've this little emergency theatre. I think complicated operations are always done in the main theatre.
Which is tied up. So let's hope he doesn't need anything too elaborate.
OK.
Thanks.
Now, Colin, all this metal that's trapped on your legs, they're going to try and get that off you and get you to the hospital. You all right?
It's just a little bit.
He's fainted.
I can barely feel his pulse. And it's racing.
It's going to take some time, this.
Would you want me to call the hospital?
Yeah, and we'll need a doctor.
Dr. Wetherall is very experienced. She wouldn't operate if you weren't sure.
Excuse me, Mr. Middleditch. The policeman's on the phone, wants a doctor. I'm not sure what to do.
What exactly is the problem, Lizzie?
The lad in the accident's turned poorly. They need a doctor out there.
I'll be back in one moment.
Right, let's have him on the table, shall we?
All right. And lift.
No one's available. Getting a doctor from outside the area will take time.
Would you like me to attend? I'd be happy to do what I could.
By Jove. Look, I realise it's a lot to ask.
Not at all. I haven't got my doctor's back.
We'll borrow Dr. Wetherall's. I'm sure she won't mind.
The policeman said he was poorly. Did he clarify that at all?
Not really.
Is he losing blood? Has he got any head injuries?
We just said it fainted.
And what about the ambulance, then? Can I talk to one of them?
They were calling from a phone box. I haven't got the number.
Besides, they only have a limited training in first aid.
At the roundabout, take the Ashfordley Road. It's about 10 miles from there.
Right, thanks. I'm on my own, just on the road. I tell you what, don't wanna move. I walk around, be off the ground. I need to go, fall down the
tinpot place.
I don't care what you say, we should have insisted they took her to Ashfordley.
Sally wasn't up to the journey.
Rubbish. I reckon that woman is just trying to make a mark as a surgeon, practising on my daughter.
Right, that's enough. Enough. Look, we should be grateful to these people. They're doing the very best that they can. They're trying to save her life. Now shut up. Just shut up.
When this old world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face. I climb way up to the top.
She's staying up.
Right, I'm going to make an exploratory laparotomy. Alan, light.
On the roof, it's peaceful as can be.
Scalpel, please. The world below
can me. Oh, no. Let me tell you now when I
come. My God, what on earth is going on? Okay, we need to prepare a casualty theatre. I can operate in there. Alan, can you give us a table?
Let's break the disconnection.
I'll make sure the corridor's clear.
Brilliant.
How's she doing?
She's stable.
Beryl, can you get some fresh sterile packs? We're going to need to regown it. Can you get some fresh gowns?
Yes, sure.
Is everyone okay?
Are you responsible for this?
No, he's not entirely. I've been asking the district treasurer to fund roof repairs for months.
He's fainted again.
What's his name?
Colin. Colin Pike.
Hello, Colin. Can you hear me?
Sweating, but he's cold. Pulse is fast. Blood pressure's way down.
He was finally out of me. He was cracking jokes, and then he just kept drifting to sleep.
He's in severe surgical shock. How long to get him out?
Half hour, apparently.
He may be bleeding internally. Steering wheel might have ruptured his spleen. What infusions have you got? Plasma, saline, glucose. What do you carry?
Spare wheel and a jack, and that's about it, I'm afraid.
What?
We're equipped to get patients to hospital as fast as possible. We're not here to mess about with them.
Would you want me to fetch something for you?
20 minutes to the hospital, 20 minutes back, say 45 minutes. We'll be on our way by then.
Oh, just hurts. It's all right, Colin. We'll get you out. Don't worry.
What on earth was that crash? Is everything all right?
Yes. There's nothing to worry about.
No, just a few loose slates, that's all.
Yeah, it sounded more like the roof coming in.
How is she?
Yeah, well, they're operating now. We'll soon know. You'd better wait in my office.
Now, look.
John, come on. Let's leave him to it.
You knew that chimney was in poor condition. What the devil were you playing at?
Mr. Middleditch, it was an accident. I'm sorry.
If the district secretary discovers that the operating theatre is out of action, he'll close us down.
Look, my cousin's a builder. Now, I'll get him round to patch it up again sharp.
You better had.
Right. Nearly there.
Hurry up, we're losing him. Get the door.
Right, I've untwisted the cyst. Two clamps for the pedicle, please. If we can remove this quickly, there's a good chance we can save the ovary before the rest of the hospital collapses.
That's good, guys. All right, just lay him down here. Colin? Colin? Colin, can you hear me? Eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Come on. Damn it.
Looks benign.
Right, send that to histology. Pray that we got her in time. Right, ligatures, please. Let's get this tied off.
Come on, Colin, come on! 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Natalie, my darling.
Mum.
She'll need several days complete rest. She's on quarter hourly obs until ward round tomorrow, nurse.
She will be all right, though, won't she?
Well, the swelling subsided and the blood flow's restored. She's making an excellent recovery.
Thank you, Doctor. We're so grateful.
She's in safe hands, Mrs. Rutter. We'll soon have her home.
Bye-bye, sweetheart.
Bye.
Thank you. You did a good job. Listen, I'm sorry if I... my only daughter.
No, I do understand.
We'll call back to see you in the morning. Come on, John.
Oh, well done, John.
Oh, what, for the op or for getting an apology out of Rotter?
Well, it's been a long day. And we still have one outstanding matter to deal with. Cheriton, don't be too hard on him. He's had a tough time out of that accident, I gather.
Well, it's a tough job he's applying for.
Rod said they'll be in the secretary's office. Poor man. He looks really upset.
Yeah, some day he's had. Pity, we could have used someone like him around here.
Aren't they going to offer him the job?
Word is Dr. Jill's put her foot down.
I'm sorry, but could you write up your notes before you leave? We'll need them prior to the post-mortem.
It's going to be tricky.
Oh? Why?
Or should I put down ruptured spleen or sheer incompetence?
No. You mustn't blame yourself. You couldn't have done any more than you did.
I could with the right equipment.
Well, you had my GP's bag, didn't you?
I needed an intravenous infusion set. A supply of fluids, plasma, basic stuff to stand any chance at all.
But we have all that in casualty, Doctor.
Well, it's no damn use when you have emergencies and remote spots miles away from anywhere. Time is so vital with these injuries. In places like this, if a doctor's called out, he should routinely carry that kit.
A portable kit? Oh, my dear fellow. The district treasurer wouldn't even consider it. Have you any idea what that would cost?
Yes, about £200. What price would your treasurer put on Colin Pike's young life? Wasn't he worth a lousy £200? If you'll excuse me, I've got a long drive home.
Didn't like to let you down. We'll do the best we can.
It'll be in the way there, Alan. Can we move her further back against the wall?
Television in the ward? Whatever next?
I can think of a few things you need more urgently around here.
I really am sorry about what happened at the accident. Well, we don't live in a perfect world, I'm afraid.
So it seems.
Middleditch does have a lot to contend with, you know. A district treasurer with a very bad case of beetle mentality when it comes to cottage hospitals.
Beetle mentality?
A beetle has six legs. So you take one off for economy. Then, because it doesn't walk straight, you remove another one. You know, just to even things up. Well, now, of course, it walks too slowly. So you say, well, it doesn't work. Might as well kill it off.
That applies here.
The treasurer thinks we're a drain on resources. He'd like our money for Ashville General. So he starves us of funds and then says we don't work.
Chops your legs up, closes you down. Shame. Hospitals like this are needed.
Oh, we'll fight him to the end. I hope you're going to be part of that fight. I sense you'd enjoy it.
Thank you. But I don't think your colleagues share your view.
Excuse me. We've been having a chat. That was pretty hard-hitting stuff in there.
Don't worry, I'm on my way. Just saying goodbye.
Well, we've got something to say too, actually.
We were very impressed by your passion and by your ideas and by your work today. And we'd very much like to offer you a place in the partnership.
Absolutely.
Starting ASAP, I suggest. Well, that is if you still want the job.
Yes. I'd like it very much. Thank you. Thank you.
That's a very good reception you have there, Alan.
We have Ken to thank for that, sister.
He's working, Dad. It's fab. Really fab.
Oh, I am pleased. Hey, Lizzie, will you do me a favour, love?
Yeah?
Will you have a look in TV Times and tell me what time the epilogue finishes?
I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above, and the sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love.
Patient collapsed with a tropical fever or something. Apparently he's just returned from the West Indies.
Is he conscious?
Yes, he is. Yeah. I hope I'm not nil by mouth and all, because the food on the plane was diabolical. It was even worse on the train because there weren't any.